Here's our project for our wiggly wobbly paper effect. Above all layers, we need to add a square shape and make it fill up the whole screen. Next, go to Effects and add the Displacement Map effect from the Distortion Wob category. This will allow the other effects we add to be applied to the whole project like a filter, instead of being bound to a single layer. Leave the effect as is, no need to adjust it. Add another effect called Fractal Warp from the same category. This will give the picture that wiggly wobbly effect. However, this effect is too smooth, so we'll have to add another effect to make it look like there are fewer frames. This effect is unanimated by default and messed up. Go into the effect settings and lower the magnitude, which controls the intensity of the effect's distortion. I like to keep it between 0.030 to 0.060. Now we'll animate the effect. You can animate either the position or parallax. They move slightly differently. I'll animate the parallax by adding a parallax keyframe, then head to the end of the layer, and you can move the scrolls or just swipe on the preview and the parallax will move. As you can see, detail increases the detail of the effect. No detail just makes the layer float. And you may ask, what does lacunarity do? It also increases the detail. And the octave also increases the detail. Just play around with them until you get something you like. I like this. Final effect. Add the time quantization effect from the other category. Time quantization allows you to lower the frames displayed per second. The higher the steps, the smoother the animation. The lower, the more steppy. I find 5 to 7 steps per second to be the best for a wiggly wobbly paper effect. Of course, you can still go and adjust the fractal warp effect to your liking. As long as the layer with the three effects is on top of this new picture, the effect will work! You can also save this as a preset to reuse it. Just take the layer with the three effects. From here, pick Save Preset. To use it on new projects, just add a square, make it fill the project composition, and pick your preset from the presets. Since the effects are getting added to the square and the square layer is acting as a filter, you can still adjust the effect settings. Who named this tutorial? My people! For paper lovers, you can bring in a paper texture and the crumpled up paper looks amazing with this effect. I'll take my sketch, color burn it. That leaves us with this cool effect.